Hey there everyone, it's Luis, aka M from Up Your Geek. We are here at YumaCon 2016, the second YumaCon, I believe. And we're gonna just head out to the event, see what's up, what's going on, talk to people as well. So, let's go. Arizona Ghostbusters. They come to Comic-Con to hear. So the Arizona Ghostbusters. They were here last year as well. And we're going to talk to them in a little while. This is basically the vehicle we're going to take to the conventions. Ghostbusters, that's the one you're talking about?
I've not seen that, I don't know about that.
So let's go.
There's gangster.
DVDs and stuff right there, merchandise.
Is this the classic one? What's the? Yeah, it's the classic one.
I see Echo Coolers.
This is cool.
They have the book from the new movie.
And it's pretty cool.
I guess.
Did you dope? What's the big idea? Hey, what's that filler?
Put that together.
Actually, our team's captain.
I put together a Millennium Falcon. It took me 4 hours.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And that's because you didn't move from that table.
Hi, so what are the Arizona Ghostbusters?
Okay, what the Arizona Ghostbusters basically is, we're an organization based out of Phoenix. We're the actual Yuma chapter. What we do is we go around for charity events, that type of things. Everybody wants to come out, they want to see our cool gear, they want to see our cool cars. You know, it just attracts more people. Like today we're helping out Habitat for Humanity, and that's where all the raffle items are.
So, is your raffle items?
These are all raffle items right here.
Oh.
Basically, what you do is you buy a raffle ticket, we draw it every hour. They don't even have to be present for our Yuma people. And then, they get to pick their price.
So like Comic-Con, like Comic-Care? You know Comic-Care? No. They go to like, and they're in Phoenix, I think?
Like I said, we're part of the Yuma chapter, so I don't know anything about Phoenix. We do have our actual Arizona Ghostbusters president saying right there, chowing down right now. But.
So this was built, right?
Huh?
You built this? Or
yep, all this has been hand-built. There are a few things we did purchase, but not too many things.
So are you an engineer?
No, we just like building stuff. Like most of our packs, everything of that nature, we built all out of hand. Most of the stuff on the car, there's an old scuba tank, an old water softener parts up there. Whatever we could basically find to make it look somewhat
authentic.
Very cool.
Are you going to be like in a cosplay contest?
We don't do that anymore. The only time we actually enter into a cosplay contest is if there's money involved. And then that way, if we win, we get our charity of that night all the money.
Oh, nice.
That's the only way that we'll enter.
Oh, okay.
And if it's for baskets, stuff like that, we'll let the kids enter and have fun. But.
We're doing, yeah, we're covering. We're finally hanging out.
We're back.
Here we are in the booth. It seems to be like some sort of a contest as well.
This is the whole movie.
Again. It's too bad that I only have like $20. Because if I had like more, I could maybe buy them. try to do it. Maybe. If I had the money.
There's like these tournaments, such as Learn Wipe.
I don't know. I can't say it.
Me neither.
We got it.
We got it.
Pokemon, man. Classic Pokemon.
It works!
Pretty cool clothes.
Seriously though, I'm surprised they're still in business. I'm also surprised not to see the Hippos for the Sinnoh.
The Hippos for the Sinnoh? That sounds good.
Very nice collection.
It is.
Amazing collection. Whole box of figures, minifigs. Very awesome stuff. Hello! We are a press.
You're who? You're a mess?
Yes, we are. So, what is this?
This is Michael's Custom Playhouse. We are here promoting all of our custom work that we do. So, anything that you bring into Michael's, you can bring in comic books,
action figures, pins, cards, pictures, canvases. We've done pretty much everything you can think of.
We can frame it.
Yep.
We can frame a brick.
We frame fossils. We frame rocks.
Yes.
Yeah.
So you take anything and you frame it?
We can do that. Yep. We can put it in a shadow box, kind of like this. Or we can do more of a traditional style and put it with mats and frame.
Shadow box is better. Yeah. It looks better.
Yeah. We've done quite a bit of stuff here in Yuma for a lot of people. A lot of people on military base, stuff like that. So.
All these people. Nothing that memorable.
So from the consistency, let's go from there to there, like last time.
All right.
Hello?
Hi.
Oh, hello.
So, what are these?
What's up,
man? Sorry.
What are these?
Those are pixel arts. We have a link right there. Tons of stuff from Smash, Pokemon, Minecraft, My Little Pony.
What do you need?
Are you recording it?
Some Dragon Ball Z in there.
Oh, yeah.
It's got a little bit of everything.
The only one I have.
$15, right?
The only one I have is at the house. I brought it there because I thought we were
going to be on the floor.
I took it out.
Remember when you had the price?
I took it out of the locker. And I'm at
Moonlight Sprites.
Yes, Moonlight Sprites.
She has a booth, so I'm helping her with this.
So is this what you do?
I'm at
UmaCon. What I do. I'll give you my business card.
She has a booth.
If you like the page, you can see what events I go to. I'm local here in Yuma, but I do go out to like SoCal for some tournaments and events there too.
Sorry about that. Oh, when you called yesterday, I was knocked out, bro. Were you good?
Thank you. Yes, I
with that material right there.
All
right.
These are perler beads. So all you do is you get your pegboard, you lay it out, and then once you're done, you place the perler bead paper or ironing paper over top, you iron it, flip it over, iron the other side, and that's it.
You know
So yeah, they're pretty they're pretty strong, so you can bend them and they won't break.
Very cool.
And you can pick them up, that's fine.
Eggo! Where's my Eggo?
11. So is this for cost of repair?
Yeah. Like if something happens, then you can just come back to your... If we have stuff to help you out.
Very nice.
So like if something happens,
somebody's classroom right now, like the box just kind of split open. And then they just hot back together.
The person in charge of the booth isn't here right now. She'll be here like at 1:15 around there. But we're just helping out, just filling her out.
Oh, very nice. Good costumes, by the way.
Thank you.
Yeah, sure. That's what I got.
Oh yeah, I got all this. It's all just
a video about.
Do you have a Facebook page for Claire?
I believe she does.
Is that the business card?
Yeah, you already have the business card.
Right? I got the business card.
There's Facebook and Lulu.
Yeah, I'm recording.
I'll be posting the thing on the Facebook pages. Yeah.
If you know about the Yuma cosplayers, you can probably share it there too.
Oh, yeah, I did. Yeah,
we'll check it out then.
These are Jamboree nail wraps, and they go on your nails. They're like stickers.
And then the last step,
so
you just
do
put
this,
it right back in front, like a few seconds.
No.
Yeah, well, we sell them, and then you actually do them yourself at home.
It's very relaxing.
And then you can use your finger.
So you heat it up, and then you put it on your nail. You want to try it?
You want to try it?
What?
And that's it.
Do you want to try it?
For free?
No dry time, no tipping.
Sure.
Okay. Super fun. Okay, you're nice. You can do your other stuff too if you want.
Very rough.
Okay. Yes. Go ahead and pick one out.
Ready to go.
Oh my, wait. Sure.
And then I would just cut the length.
Yeah, that looks good.
Yes, just cut it in half.
That one?
Sure.
Yep.
Okay.
So how do I do this?
Let me see. It's going to go on your... Right there. Yeah, that one. Alright. So go ahead and wipe off your nail with that.
Which one?
Yeah, that one. The one you're going to put it on. It's just alcohol to get all the oils and dirt off.
I use the pointy side. Alright.
Okay.
Yeah.
So then, done.
Heat it up again.
Good. And then smooth it down.
Center and side, and then other side.
All right, nice.
And then file off the excess. Oops, sorry about that. In a downward motion, like this. Yeah.
Alright.
And then just peel it off. Did you? Okay, awesome. And then just heat it up again. Smooth it down to get a nice good seal.
That'd be nice just to have the heater for all your ends.
Yeah.
In the winter especially.
Yeah, I know, huh? And then you're done.
Well, thank you.
Oh, yeah. Awesome.
That is pretty cool.
Just 3 seconds, right?
Yeah, just a view. Yeah.
For real.
So do you have a Facebook page for your...
I do actually have a Facebook page, and then there's this is the website on here, and then
three, maybe those are like 4.
I'll write down my Facebook page.
A couple times,
so
yeah, and then you're...
My Facebook page is sarahsnailaddicts.facebook.com.
Abnormal hearts.
It could be.
be the blue-hooded, I think it's the shirt design or something. Yeah, I'm talking about the hearts right there.
How many minutes
does Freddy find you? That's
cool design. Just get the part.
He found you in that time?
Yeah. So do you make the shirts?
Yeah, I design them. These are my two sisters. We started a company, the three of us.
Called Abnormal Hearts?
Yeah, Abnormal Hearts. And we named it Abnormal Hearts because we have transplants and then she has a heart disease. But we wanted people to know that your circumstances don't have to defy you, that you can overcome anything. So we wanted people to know that no matter what, they can always accomplish what they want to do.
That is an awesome message.
Thank you, man. Thank you. So yeah, dude, we made superheroes with scars because we wanted little kids to not be ashamed of their scars, as long as with adults, you know, never be ashamed of,
oh, yeah,
of who you are. So
goes both physically and emotionally. You know, everyone has scars.
This is true.
All right. So how long does it take to make this?
You mean, did you say how long it took?
Yeah, did you?
Sure. Well, the designs I made myself, but we actually had to pay to get them printed somewhere. So it took about probably a week. So, yeah. And the designs took a little longer, but it's something that we've had in the work for a while, but just kind of finally physically brought it out about 6 months ago.
Yeah. And how do I win a hoodie?
If you have Instagram and Facebook, like us, follow us, and that's it, man. You're in.
So, like, do you guys also do charity events or something?
We do. Well, right now, what we actually do too is, like, we donate 15% of every shirt that we sell. Right now, we're actually trying to, like, buy 3DSs to donate to the hospitals so kids can play while they're hospitalized. But, yeah, that's pretty much it. I mean, we do work with other foundations that help kids go, like, heart camp and stuff like that. But pretty much is all we do right now.
Sure, I got them.
Okay. All right, hi. Hi.
Hey.
Yes. We're going to have one this May 6th. It's a free comic book day again, and it's a free entrance. And free comics. What else we have? Also, we have the main library. We have the adult anime club. They watch anime, they play board games, you can bring your own snack. We have the teen anime club and the teen manga club. If you are in the San Luis area, we have the San Luis anime club. And they meet up every Wednesday for 2 hours. First hour is they watch anime. The second hour it can be crafts, trivia, or video games that we play. This is the Heritage Library program for December. They do D&D and a few other board game activities.
So do you actually make
some items? So you're just giving out permission to the Yuma library?
Yeah, it's in the programs that we have based on comics, anime, and any popular arts. Also, one more thing. If you guys are interested in trivia, the library is hosting a panel at 4 p.m. in the East Wing 4 based on comics, anime, and TV trivia, like Jeopardy style. So you can bring it with your own team, or we can put you up with another team there. Okay?
Very cool.
That's my current suit for. And then, all of these pieces on this guy.
I know they've got a lot of people in the groups out there now that are doing that kind of stuff. I'm looking for people.
Yeah. And I, the group I run.
So did you make it yourself?
Yeah.
How long did it make it?
It took about 2 or 3 months. Yeah, 2 or 3 months.
We do have free
software.
This was the first Halo suit I made. Then I've kind of improved a little bit too.
A little bit?
It's alright.
It's just they don't have.
So are you two together or just you?
I'm a guest judge here for the masquerade. So everything you see here, and then like what we're wearing are props that I've made. I'm just modeling it.
And is Deadpool with you as well?
What was it?
Deadpool.
Yeah. Well, Deadpool is his own something.
Deadpool is always his own entity.
That's true.
So you made all this?
Yeah.
Also,
if you're they're short, so I'm like, I don't know how to
put a lot of cool stuff.
Like, do you make it from materials that you find like in your house, or like do you buy some of them?
Yeah, so there's always like a little bit of both. It just kind of just really depends on like what you're making. Like my sword up here is going to be carved down and then sanded down from a piece of wood. These guys I literally cut and then wore blood within foam to get like that angle, so that two pieces that were flat and then just push them together. This stuff is all like foam formats, and then you've got like your different sizes of foam. So that would be those two. You can do like googly eyes for like your rivets, just different sizes depending on like what you're doing. You could have some like up here.
Really
different
fun.
Size googly eyes. Ping pong balls for the eyes. So yeah, stuff that you can find from home. Absolutely.
Very creative.
Very.
I really want to do like.
Like your shirt, by the way.
Thanks.
That's awesome.
Did someone important sign your Halo?
Oh yeah, Steve Downs, the voice actor of Master Chief, whoever signed it.
Whoa.
Yeah, that's
really awesome.
Well, that's what I mean. You can really make.
Yeah, it was really cool, dude. Yeah.
That's why it's not very complex.
It was weird because like his normal voice sounds like his Master Chief voice, so it's kind of like, oh my god, this is intense.
Watch it.
Also, want the anti venom.
The upside down.
Yeah. But I could never really.
Very cool stuff.
Thank you.
Are you going to be like in the cosplay contest?
Oh, we're judges. We're judges.
Okay.
So, along with that.
So that's why you're put together, not separate, like.
Yeah, I guess so.
I was wondering about that.
There's supposed to be somebody else over there too. They don't show up here.
No, that's.
Well, yeah, how are you?
Good.
Did you write the books?
Yeah, we did. And we do everything.
Very cool.
So we'll list the posters.
Sorry?
The posters as well.
Yeah, feel free to flip through that. There's a ton of images in there. That's all the same shit that we told the story through a fantasy book series. Those were the short novels there. And then now we're turning into a manga series as well. This is just the first arc of four of
them. You're dying, yeah.
Yeah. I saw this earlier and I was like, yeah, I
there's the main guy for here.
Oh, the first born.
Art by Sean Lamb. Yeah, you just open it up and there's
critics.
Are you getting it?
Yeah.
Did you get the cards already?
Those are not cards, I think those are stickers.
Yeah,
there's nothing on the other side of that.
Oh, yeah.
Have you watched Parasite Maxing yet?
Alright, get the info.
So
right.
I
already got it. I'll get it again.
Okay. So how long did it take you to write the books?
Writing them or including editing?
Writing.
It took me probably like 4 months.
And with the editing?
4 years.
All the
writing is easy.
Yeah. I also asked you about it earlier.
It's a blank page, you can do whatever you want. It's only when you come back to it that you're like,
story and copy it.
Put all five books for years.
I wrote 10 of these in one go, and it took me about 5 months, maybe six.
As far as like from conception all the way to the end, or 5 years?
Seven. I'd say they're still in my head. They're still like,
so you're true with Cloud?
Oh, okay.
And what about Four Lords?
Me and him and two other guys who are grabbing some stuff.
And Sean Lamb is not here?
Sean is not here. Sean is lives in another country along with our artist who lives in Paris. And
there's a lot of it.
Yeah, size team.
This just happened.
Although this year we had everyone at the anime.
That all was pretty good.
Dude, if you like fantasy, the finale, it's a good series, man. Anime in style,
you know, the story arcs
are pretty mellow. The graphic novels are fun, they follow the exact same story.
Well, the first issue opens up in the diner they're in at the end.
Yeah.
That's how it opens up. It's like, oh,
what about the manga?
Let's talk about what happened.
Sorry.
It took us about a year and a half to get that done, but also when the artist first comes on, it takes a long time for them to adapt to the style. They have to learn the story, they have to learn the character. Second book should only take about 6 months.
Can you look at these two?
Yes, I and my brother both wrote Serving Soup and Inspector Toad. He draws Serving Soup, and I draw Inspector Toad. The Serving Soup is a workplace comedy because there's been a bunch of deconstruction of superheroes done by people way more brilliant than we are. Our series concentrates on the idiocy of the people working in the office. Their job is they serve court documents to deadbeat superheroes and supervillains. They got no powers themselves. They weren't real good at their jobs.
The second one, it wasn't scary.
Inspector O is follows the travels of two exorcists in medieval China.
That's the thing. James Cameron didn't think so.
And we're super duper proud of the.
Yes.
Yeah. In the back of every issue.
I tried to make those.
We include illustrated footnotes so that the reader can learn a little bit more about Chinese mythology.
Hammered in.
Very cool.
With explosive tip casings. Yeah, and so I'm sitting there walking around and I put a shoulder strap on.
How long did it take to like make it?
Oh, I loved it.
Every issue usually takes about a month from beginning to end. Sometimes about 6 weeks. But we
he did not do aliens.
We tend to do all of the stuff. We do all the art, we do all the coloring, the lettering, the writing. And so it's just essentially a two-man show. Most other comic books that you see from other publishers. The artist is one guy, the letterer is another, the colorist is yet a third, and on and on.
Really?
There's a lot more division of effort with other publishers. With our series, we don't have that sort of division of labor because we're kind of control freaks with our properties. The lettering process normally. That's where we get our last rewrites in.
So. Thanksgiving and we get together at the house. We swap.
What about you guys? You guys creators?
We swap stories. We swap.
Create your own stuff.
Do you have an idea for a comic?
And stuff that's hard to find.
I've been having it on there for a long time.
I like soak it all in.
Just
got done with like the series.
Trying to get it together.
Yeah.
Like the basic idea.
Okay.
We actually met a graphic design class.
Oh, sweet. Yeah. Yeah. So you guys have got the art angle covered, right?
Yeah.
Okay. That's the big bottleneck in the whole creative process, because everyone is like, oh, I've got this great story, it's going to be 300 pages, it's going to be awesome, epic, and I can't draw. So it's like, that's the worst part. Because you pay someone a page rate, that's a lot of money, or you can't afford to pay them much, and you might get a page a year later, 2 years later.
Can process that.
We do have one friend, and mad respect to him because he had all these ideas, but he couldn't draw. So he took a bunch of art classes. And so we're like, yes. Okay.
Night Stalker in RRH. All right. Night Stalker. She is a demonic detective from hell. So the basic premise is we have several creatures who are in hell, and they actually bust the gates of hell open, and they escape, and they actually make it to Earth, and they hide. Now, she's a demon herself, and she's been contracted by the Dark Lord to figure out who the creatures are, track them, capture them, drag them back to Earth. But as you know, they're not going to go back to hell willingly. They actually have the ability to time jump. So what she has to do is chase them through different time periods of Earth. Now, she's African American, and these creatures are pretty ruthless. So, in reality, what the creature says that we know, since he has the ability to time jump and chase us, we know just where to go to hide from her. So the creature said, we're going to go to 1800s Mississippi to hide out. Not exactly the best time for African Americans back then. So you have this high-ranking demon who now has to bow down to the status quo of the time, still do her job and capture these creatures, and not change the past in order to automatically affect the future. So it gets real hectic real quick. Now, say a typical comic book is 22 pages, right? Our book, 64 pages. So you get the whole first arc of the story and everything. So, you know, we want to give you as much as we could on the book. And so that's why it's so thick and so heavy. You get a lot of story, you get a lot of everything in there. So what we did right there in your hand, that's the original version, the regular cover right here, with her and Azrael. She has a Hellion. You know how Batman has Robin? Well, Diana has Azrael. And we did the limited edition cover. We only did 1,000 of those. And this cover is limited edition, only 1,000. It's a beautiful cover, too. I said that she looks like a real person, and we really made her up. What would she look like? And that's kind of what we came up with right there. So we wanted her to look pretty, you know, sexy, but pretty cool. And that's a goblin there named Pookie. So that's her and her goblin on this one. That's her and Pookie here, and then her and Azrael here. Same book. This is where we introduce her nemesis. You know, every superhero, every villain or hero has to have a nemesis. Well, she's got her nemesis. We created her nemesis here. And he is he's really, really, really something else. And also, this is the only time we actually will show what she looks like as a demon. This is her normal figure, what she looks like as a normal person. But the only time we'll ever show what she actually looks like as a demon, we did a pinup of her on this page right here. And that's what her true self looks like in her demon form, which is actually, you know, pretty cool. So this is a special edition version we did where, again, we show her as a demon, and we introduce her nemesis.
Okay. What about
RRH? Now, you know the story of Little Red Riding Hood, right? Our version is a little bit different. In our version, the wolf uses Ancestry.com to trace Little Red Riding Hood's lineage. And the wolf actually finds Little Red Riding Hood's 10th generation, her great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-granddaughter. When the wolf finds her, he kidnaps her and actually starts to torture her for what happened 800 years ago. Now this girl, her name is Sydney. She has no idea she's even related to Little Red Riding Hood. All she knows is this nutcase has kidnapped her and is doing what he's doing. Well, she'll eventually be rescued by a creature she never knew existed, and she'll be transformed and will eventually become the most lethal assassin the world has ever seen. And she'll specialize in killing werewolves. And it all happens on her 17th birthday. This book, we're up to issue 10 right now. The trade just came out. And we're going to have some roots in Japan. It's going to go all the way to feudal Japan. And they said, you know, people are really, you know, reacting well to both Night Stalker and RRH. And thus are the stories.
That's exactly
right. So you made
everything? Uh-huh. Uh-huh. I created everything. I'm the creator and the writer. I'm not the artist. I have an artist out of Mexico named Andres Esparza, who's a really good artist. But people, you know, people are really, really react to Night Stalker well, really react to RRH well. Obviously, Servant Suits, Inspector O. I mean, and that's the beautiful thing about First Comics, Devils Do First Comics. We have a variety. And we'll take it somewhere where the big boys won't. They won't take it there. So say you look at RRH right here. Just gives you a sample of the kind of work we put into a book. I always go to this page, when the wolf first reveals himself. Look at that artwork. You can't get much better than that. You're not going to see that on hardly any other kind of levels, but you know, we really do take it there. And you flip the page, when the wolf finally transforms, that's what it looks like. And this is in the middle of the kidnapping, and you can see Sydney, she's still bound to the chair, trying to fight the wolf, bound to a chair.
Okay.
And I mean, it's important because, you know, a lot of times, once people discover us and read our story, they're like, whoa, we never knew this stuff was out there. Obviously, Marvel and DC are the big guys out there, and, you know, they have the, you know, the biggest pockets and everything, but they're, you know, the independents, they need support. Plain and simple. We, again, we'll go places where Marvel and DC won't, and people don't want the same story done. I mean, how many times has Robin died? How many times has Superman been killed?
Why doesn't everybody they, start injecting?
There's not too much more you can do with the same characters and still make it interesting. But they've been doing it because they've been around for a long time. But once fans come over to the independents, like, hey, what's this independent title about? What, you know, what's this about? We explain it to them. They're like, whoa, I never heard anything like that before. I got to check this title out. And that's why we do as well as we do. But of course, we could always do better. And so that's why I always ask. I mean, just the fact that you guys even came by the table, we're pumped with that because we need support. We need to get, you know, word out there that there are cool stories like RH, like Night Stalker, like Servant Suits, like Inspector O, that they're out there. But the masses don't know that.
Yeah. Where are you guys based out of?
We are based out of Chicago. But as creators, we live all over the place. I used to live in Yuma, and that's why they invited me to the show. I was in Yuma, I was in the foothills, and I broke into comics while I was living in Yuma.
Okay, good. That's where I broke in.
I was, you know, I was a writer, a struggling writer, trying to make it, trying to do it, and I was always going to these cons and showing my work and everything. And finally, I found Devil's Due First Comics. I was just like, hey, I got this story. Take a look at it. I think it's really cool, and I think it's something different. And they looked at it and like, whoa, you're right, this is different. And then they picked me up right along. So, you know, no matter where you live, whether in Yuma, I'm in Palm Springs. I just moved from Yuma a little while ago. But I was out here, you know, I was out here for 8 years in Yuma. My daughter, you know, she went to Yuma Lutheran. She went to Yuma Lutheran. Southwestern Christian and everything like that. So I'm really pumped that they offered me a chance to come back to the show. And it gives you guys a chance to get a little bit more variety, you know.
Blaze Brothers is
a Revolution Comics.
Yeah, that's where this is where I self-published. I self-published on a Revolution. And then we were picked up by First Comics. And that's where we went from Revolution Comics to First Comics.
And which one?
Yeah, these are all the rest of our books now will have these symbols. And then First Comics combined with Devil's Due First Publishing. And so now we're Devil's Due First Comics.
Of course, you guys have the art staff.
We'll be making a video about it.
Okay. I appreciate that. I'm glad you guys even, if you need anything at all, let me know. Contact us and we'll help you with whatever you need.
Look, a card for the...
Are the writers and artists for Servant Suits and Inspector O? We have about 20 other people there.
Puzzle versus Predator. That's some good stuff.
How are we doing,
guys? It's going well. How are you?
So behind me, these are my originals. These are some paintings. These are some ink sketches I did. And then I have them scanned, and then I make the prints in them. You ever seen them in concert?
Huh?
You ever seen them in concert?
No.
They do an amazing show. Some people get up there, you know, like, eh, whatever they sing. These guys put on freaking performance. Eddie comes out, they have fireworks, explosions, fire, zip lines across the stage, you know, Bluetooth guitars. It's amazing. Like, oh, I'm sitting in the back, it's not going to be very well. And, you know, you're sitting in the back and you're going like, wow, they're all over the place.
I never understood why people would like sing with them as well, like when you're in concert and you sing as well with them. Until I went to a concert myself, out of nowhere I started singing as well with them. And I understood why. They get pumped up. How long did it take you to make them?
It depends. Like this one, I probably spent like 30 hours on this one. About that, the same on that one. This one I did, Cliff Simon, I spent 60 hours on that one. So he gave me this 8x10 photograph. He goes, what can you do from this? And so I had this little sketch and I sent it to him. He's like, oh, okay, because I've seen your work. As long as, yeah, you know, I kind of explained what I was thinking of and like put some stuff in the background. And so then that was kind of a. Our agreement, I sent him like a big poster and 50 prints with my little sticker on the back, and That was all, you know, so just do that, and yeah, paint away, sell as many as you can. So that was our licensing fee. Me doing a painting and giving him like a couple prints. So he's a pretty cool guy if you ever get a chance to meet him. I don't know if you're a Stargate fan, but he played like the coolest bad guy on TV. He like always escaped. If you think he's dead, he's not dead. I still don't think he's dead. They finally think they kill him. He's alive. Somewhere.
Do you make him on Photoshop after?
Pardon? Do what?
Do you like do it on Photoshop after?
No, that's all. This is all. These are all real paintings. This background is airbrushed in, and that was done by hand. I mean, you can see where I'm like painting it right there. A little bit of the process. I almost brought the painting, but I was trying to get more paintings of like the fantasy stuff and then Hamburg and stuff. She's against her.
She's like, oh. I'm like, no, it's okay. I'm like, oh. So I try and make them at least all like top.
Why am I doing that?
Stuff like that. So
that's good.
And they're like, wait, so I put them on and I actually get them in here, honestly. With even the like Kunari ones, those big round ones. Like the only time I remember that I'm wearing them is when I go to
Hi guys.
Hello.
How are you?
Good. Are you a cosplayer?
I am a prop maker. I do cosplay as well, but I'm a professional prop maker. So I make horns and headpieces, and I build armor and weapons and stuff like that. And that's my full-time job. Making stuff that shouldn't exist in real life, making it exist. So.
Do you like take everyday materials and
I'm sorry, what?
Like taking everyday materials and making them?
Oh, 100%, 100%. A lot of my costumes have things that, like I did this really cool Mass Effect armor, and I actually, for part of it, in the back it has like these round parts. I actually took my sewing machine, bob, like my old thread things, and put them down and used them as a base. So cosplay is a lot of using things in a creative way that you might not have thought of until you got into it. And you're like, oh, hey, this fits right here. Yay. So, and a lot of my work is specialty as well. So I do a lot of mold making and casting. So that's pretty specialty stuff. But I like to be a jack of all trades.
Did you make the...
Yeah. So these are made out of EVA foam, wrapped with vinyl to give them that very classic, you know, boxer glove look. So they're actually pretty soft and flexible, pretty comfortable for me to use. But the vinyl gives them a really good finish and makes them pretty durable. So I like them. They're pretty comfy, pretty snazzy. What? I know.
Man.
I saw him and I was like, "Oogie Boogie." He's like, "There's Will." And I was like, "Oh, of course Will knows."
I have no idea. That's cool. Wow.
Remember, did you ever watch Joker?
Yeah.
That guy, who was supposed to do
that? Yeah.
My wife.
My wife. Yeah, the black and white. Yeah.
Salvador Dali in there, dude.
Yeah, Mobius.
There's a button.
This dude that inspired.
So what are the Mandalorian mercs?
Mandalorian mercs are all the Boba Fetts of Star Wars. So basically, all your bounty hunters, your Bo-Katans. What's the new one? Fen Rao, the new one that way. On that side. Basically, that's what you do. You get together, you make the armor and stuff, and you have a lot of fun.
And you sweat.
And I
sweat a lot.
Absolutely.
You can imagine. It's one metal, right?
That one's metal.
Yeah, have you ever watched
that one's plastic. All right. Yep. Resin, metal, PVC.
I wish they would get more better on the
helmet. Thanks.
No, not like your helmet. I'm talking about the actual helmet.
You're based in Arizona, right?
What's that?
Based in Arizona?
We're based out of, actually, the National Club itself is based out of Alabama. That's where Mandalorian Mercs is. We're the Shonair Vakadla clan, UNC clan, Mandalorians. Most of us are in Phoenix. We've got a couple guys in Yuma now, Jaden here and Sid behind me. So we'll grow the clan out here in the Dune Sea.
You won't be here.
Get the Jundland Waste, you know, back up and running.
Do our best.
So
Like, do you do reenactments?
What's that?
Of Star Wars?
We don't do reenactments. We do photo shoots. We'll all go out and play in the dunes once in a while.
There was the one reenactment in January, I believe.
That was the reenactment. That was the dunes photo shoot. We do that every year. We started out really small. We actually put it on from Phoenix when we came down here. Then the city picked it up. So, it's a lot of fun. Yeah, we come out and play.
I was thinking about going that time, but I just didn't go.
Yeah, they're doing another one in February. February 4th, I believe.
Awesome. For my 14th birthday, can I call you?
What's that?
The dunes.
Yep, back out of the dunes. Yep. And you've got enough time, more than enough time to jump on the board and make your armor. And come out and play with us.
How long did it take you to make the suits and everything?
You know what? If you really put your time to it, you can do it in a couple weeks or 4 weeks. You can take as long as you want. Because basically, you can sacrifice quality for speed. So, you know, you gotta go back and forth that way and stuff like that. You can throw one together for a con in a couple of weeks. You can throw one together to get approved in a couple of weeks to a couple of months. I was on the board for about a year before I decided to get together and actually make it. It took me... So the course of a couple of weekends, cutting up different pieces, shaping them with the heat gun, put the magnets on them, learn to sew a vest, the vest pattern. So that's the big thing. You learn how to do different things.
Mike,
so, yeah.
You
want to
make your armor stronger
against me? Yeah, where I work, I learned how to do machining, so I learned how to do metal. So
you've
got more guys that have full metal. So,
I'm keeping this. All right. You're not getting this.
Remember, I'm your boss.
For how long?
But you take wooden PVC, you know, blasters like this, just the rest of them on the table over there. A lot of fun to play with them,
too. Did you just super?
No, that's an E6000.
Oh, yeah, I've worked that.
E6000.
Ever get tired of that?
Yeah, there we go. And that's what it is. But jump on the floor and come play with us, man. It's a lot of fun. Make kids like this smile.
Hey, I can try to destroy him. Why, you're so easy to destroy.
Lindy.
Oh, that's a really good one. Kind of updated the portfolio since last year quite a bit.
Yeah, a little bit, yeah.
Got it.
Is it pretty much shooting at the beginning? Yeah.
That's...
Or is it friends by me?
I got one. Excuse me.
Oh my god!
I'd like to call you serious if we can't wait at all. But I know you want one, folks.
Yes.
Oh, I got you.
Got me, boo.
Oh yeah, of course. I want some of this stuff. Big old bite.
I know, I'm like, here, I'm going to He's like, what? What are we? Oh, okay.
I lost salt, man. I told you a little fucking drenched.
You didn't want salt?
I like salt.
Oh, yeah. You want salt? We'll get you salt.
Yeah.
So, how long have you been doing the, Forgy Cosplay
people. For you Cosplay, we've been doing it for 2.5 years.
This is like last year, it was a year and a half in YumaCon.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Wow, so yeah.
You make the, or you just buy them?
I, for the most part, I make them. Like a sword, his sword with the sheath I bought, the shield I made, I sewed all this, in his hat, and then I made all the armor here, and the other shield that's for his link, I made those out of EVA foam, and then this part is from the bottom part of the helmet is from a kid's helmet that I just heat formed, and then, shrunk in to fit more to his face, the Ninja Turtle shell is actually a children's shell. You can buy it like Walmart, Target, just a Ninja Turtle one. And then I just repainted it. And then the Sailor Mars, a friend made for me.
Very
awesome. But for the most part, I make most of the stuff.
Was there like a show? here or just like an expo? Because I remember in the library Comic Con, there was like a little show where you like showed him and then he went and like, did his like, trick or just went around the room.
Oh, you mean like a panel?
Yeah.
We don't have any panels this weekend for this. I was like, I think she had a lot of other people signing up for panels, so she didn't ask me to do one. So I was like, oh, okay. Yeah, I'm like...
He has a cold fucking pencil.
Thank you.
Okay.
I know when you're hungry, you're just like, I'll see.
Hey, Kiba, right?
Yes,
yeah.
Kiba.
Yeah. He'll eat it.
No, it's fine.
Come here. Like a Halloween thing almost. Very nice. I like
it. So what is the UVA?
Yeah. Basically an entertainment group. We do all kinds of stuff. Right now they just taught a class on makeup and now they're doing an informal class for these to be on the
Are you based in Arizona? Are you based in Arizona?
We're in Phoenix.
Phoenix. So it's mainly like horror shows that you do?
We've done everything. Yeah, we do all kinds of stuff. We've worked in haunts, a lot of haunts. They even did it. They were zombies for a burlesque show also.
No, come over here!
We
wow.
Do everything.
Anyone that'll have you, it'll turn it into a party. So much stuff.
So, that's the good thing you told about earlier?
What?
So, remember that?
Oh, yeah. I've seen a little bit of Soul Eater.
So is this just like for selling? Booth this?
What?
Oh, is this for like selling? Yeah, this booth.
We're selling.
Yeah, you're selling.
Yeah.
Do you hand make any of the stuff?
Well, not. We bring them from Querétaro. You know where is Querétaro?
Okay. Wait, where? What? From what place?
Querétaro.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I know where
he
is.
He knows.
You didn't.
He doesn't know.
Oh, it's
in Mexico.
It's in Mexico. It's a state of Mexico.
That's cool. A lot of cool stuff.
A very nice place.
Yeah, I would say. Quite a variety, yeah.
The south is a nice place in Mexico, I heard.
Yeah.
More than the north.
More green, I imagine.
Yes, it gets greener. You know what I mean?
Sure.
So it's $2 for four? Or is it $2 for... How much is it?
$2? $2 for four. Oh. Yeah.
Only four, but I want them all.
Right?
Yeah. Cool. I'm sorry. I'm getting a token now. Yeah. Cups in here and then look at
thank you so much.
Oh my god. Look at them.
What else? Quite possibly, absolutely. Oh yeah.
I'm not sure why, but now I want to see. And it would be fun.
My dad says, you know what I mean? A lot.
A lot.
That's cool. Star Wars bang on.
Last year, you gained more in those channels that are shipped, right?
So you're going to get like way more than 80 views on this.
Dude, we got 200 views last time. Well, for 200 views.
Well, then you're going to get more than, way more than 200 this time, like for real.
Yeah.
Very cool.
Just so I know when I see it. Oh, okay.
Yeah, they have, when they have no sign up, yeah, it's kind of hard to tell.
Everybody.
Nice art.
Is this your art?
No. There's three people's art.
Oh. So
I
you're
got a man in the booth.
Oh, you're guarding the booth.
Yeah.
So there it is. It was her art, right?
It's three people.
Yeah, her is gone.
Yeah.
Okay.
Hers is just
gone. All right.
It's gonna be fast going.
Don't worry, you're not at it. We're just recording this.
Yeah. I'm gonna find it. One.
That one cool one. I might have to consider that if I ever consider wanting to make an Iron Man suit.
Yeah, Iron Man!
Or a Darth Vader suit.
Which one did you get? You got that one?
Yeah.
What about those?
Okay. It's the same card.
Oh.
Yeah. It's a friend.
That's awesome.
And then I tell everybody, you know what? Like, you like make him? Or?
Yeah, I do it all by hand. I carve it out and then put acid on it. So once everything's done by hand, it will always be original.
Yeah, yeah, there you go. Yep, right there.
Who's your favorite one?
What's wrong?
Nothing wrong.
Well,
looks like Batman and Superman to me.
It looks like Batman and Superman.
Yeah.
It looks like Henry Cavill Superman. And it looks like not Ben Affleck Batman.
I don't know what you're talking about. It looks good, though.
I mean, come on. That Batman would get his butt kicked by Superman. From that Superman.
That took me the longest to make.
So these are like 25, 35?
The small ones are 20, the large ones are 25, and the Batman Supermans, both of those are 30.
What about the comics right there? Do you make them?
He does. He makes everything himself. They're $2 a piece. He has a 3 for $5 in the packs. Maybe you'd like to add to that.
And he does a free pencil sketch over here.
He does free sketches.
Takes 5 minutes. Do you make all your beats and everything?
Oh yeah, I record myself. I make the beat myself. I did everything from scratch. This is all independent. But I edited this one. But other than that, no. I chose a photo, but the editing and the entire artwork was done by her, Michelle Coronado.
Some good Photoshop.
Oh yeah. Oh, definitely. And we just collab with each other, whether it's visual arts or audio arts. Always making something.
That's cool. That was really great.
Can you Oh, yeah. Wait, hold on. But I know that was funny. So I can remember.
Thank you, Jenna.
Thank you. And good job on the music.
I appreciate it, man.
Hi, how's it going?
Saitama-san.
Have One Punch Man.
Did you make this yourself?
Yep, so this is pretty much mine and my friend's. So we worked on this together. wanted to join you.
So, I mean, you drew all of his art?
Yep, so me and Whitney, we did. That half is mine, that her half is hers.
That is high quality.
Thank you.
It's dank. Yeah.
It's dank?
Yeah.
I'll take it.
This side is Whitney.
Whitney's that side?
This is mine. Gigi has the beans.
I got them.
Like these two are mine. And then this one continues into Whitney.
Wow. Very nice.
Oh yeah, there's art in the background.
Oh, that's smart. Yeah.
This table makes us brightest level over 9,000!
It took us a while to get that name. Before when we were cross-eyed. Because we were three artists and we're like, whoa, we're crossing different kinds of whatever.
Oh, artist God. Level over 9,000.
Yeah.
That's your name.
Yeah, that is our name.
Wow.
We started doing Comic Con, so.
Yeah, we started over at Phoenix Comic Con. This past year, this last Comic Con, we hit our 3-year mark.
How big is Phoenix Comic Con?
It's huge. I think it was about 80,000 people who attended over there to Phoenix Comic Con this year. It has grown significantly.
Maybe one day.
Going to Phoenix.
One day. I'll be moving to Phoenix.
Well, YumaCon here is like one day. Phoenix Comic Con is 4 days. So it starts Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday.
Just like almost 24/7.
Yeah, and it's not spaced out like this, and there's no like walkthrough really. Maybe like the first day, but it's still like a constant stream.
If you think this room is big, this is nothing compared to.
I don't think this room is big. I said that when I came in, right?
Yeah. Well, I mean, it's bigger than it was last year at the last place, but
still not.
Yeah, I've seen videos of like San Diego's Comic-Con and...
Well, I mean, of course, it's San Diego.
And it's, oh my God.
But yeah, it's like, it's just, at least it's good to see that it's growing.
Exactly. Exactly.
That's a good change.
Can I have beef on from the upstairs?
Yeah.
I already got some food. I need more. If
you get it, you want to take one? Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, can you get some ice out there? Yeah. I have plenty of straws.
Who did the pyramid art?
I did all the art, you see.
All of this?
Yes.
Very well done.
Thank you.
You made the
Yep, everything you see I made.
Everything? How did you make the organs?
They're just hopefully sewn together.
Oh, then you take them out. Okay, just
no, I don't take them out. There's more than one stomach there, so I don't know how that'd be physically possible.
Several bodies? I don't know.
My parents are retired cops, so I can't go that far.
Alien kitty designs.
Yes. There can be random items like plush, stickers, keychains, things you basically can't buy my table right now. You're guaranteed a good chunk of stuff in there. I mean, it is a pretty heavy little box. It's pretty full. You can weigh it.
Just look at the design on the front.
Yep, I drew each one I drew on them. That's on Tracy, that is hand drawn.
Very nice.
That is very nice.
Yeah, for $20, you get artwork and everything inside there.
Yeah, I like the alternates. I can draw too.
Yes, his nice little dragon form with a giant, huge neck.
I don't get how it's a dragon.
I don't know, but I love in like the gameplay, you can't even see his head anymore. He's like just a neck when you play with him, and his head comes down and smacks him. I'm like, I want him just for that effect. I want to be able to just smack people.
Wow.
Like, use headbutt, smack.
How long did you make them? The artwork.
How long? Depends on like the complexity. Things like the lineless style, like from like Yandere-chan or the Overwatch, take about anywhere from 1 to 2 hours. Simple stuff, like the chibi foxies and everything, are like an hour.
Are you done like in Photoshop or?
I do paint till sci for the line art and sketches, then I use Photoshop for kind of like any extra shading or any fun little effects.
Mercy. Do you want me to slide it?
Are
these all custom made?
La señora.
Yes.
How long did it take to make them?
Huh?
How long did it take to make them?
Oh, well, we have been in this for a year and a half, maybe. We're just a bunch of artists, so.
Oh, all of them.
Yeah, okay. You can have one of our cards. If one, like us.
We got a card.
Oh, you already have one?
Thank
you.
Oh,
great. Yeah, we're different artists, and we just get together at conventions, so.
I like the variety.
Yeah, that's what we're trying to do.
Do you make the covers for the notebooks or?
Yeah.
Or like a Photoshop or Illustrator or like what? Well,
yeah, we use different programs. I mean, everyone has their own style. So they use their own programs.
Mm-hmm. That was the first thing I started with.
All right, you were the illustrator, right? Both books. How did you come up with the covers?
Oh, I'm not doing covers.
You didn't do
that. Was her.
That was her?
Yeah.
Oh, you just made the.
Yeah, I said
it. Okay.
Good stuff. Hi, welcome back.
Hi.
Hello.
Are they self-published, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Amazon?
No, through Infinity.
Infinity? Like, what are they about?
Well, it's about two young girls who go on adventures.
On both books?
Yeah, both.
Right, it's for kids, right?
Uh-huh. But I mean, you read it,
I
you like them. I mean, yeah, but it's.
For any age, essentially.
You what?
For any age, essentially.
For any age, yes. Yeah.
How long did it take to write, like, the first book?
What would he say, 5 minutes earlier?
Maybe, like, 2 months.
Well, which one's the first one?
This one.
This one.
That's the first one.
That's the second.
Was it easier to write the second one, or was did it
was
take
easier.
Less? Took, like, less time?
Yeah, much less time. Maybe, like, in a week.
Wow. That's.
Yeah.
I knew like the covers.
The publisher does the covers.
Oh.
I tell them what I want and they do it.
For money, right?
Do you
have a card?
No, I don't.
Wow, tons of comic books.
Oh.
So many.
Oh,
dollar
yeah.
each.
Little book each, yeah.
These are all pins.
Who made the BB-8?
I did.
You did? Like, with,
That was an exercise ball. And this right here, I just had, like, a phone.
Okay, it worked.
I have, like, a lot of props. Oh, yeah, I painted it.
How long did it take to paint the book then?
This is, like, an hour.
You're getting it right now.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, she's very artistic. I can't do it.
I was going to make those ATSTs. Walkers.
No kidding.
But I didn't have enough time. So,
Yeah. Maybe next year.
Yeah.
I'll bring props.
Wow.
See, it says right there, make your own buttons.
Yeah, these are $2.
Do you make them?
And these are $1, I guess.
Yeah, I mean, we can try.
Can you make them right there?
Machines.
Yeah.
Alrighty.
It's kind of weird, eh?
It's unique.
Yeah. Literally, you can just get the button right in the machine.
Yeah. What you do is usually like kids will take it, they'll color it, cut it out, and then I'll put it in the machine. Shell, and then I put it on top of it,
and then a glass on top of it, a
Mylar on top of it,
and
then you press it down, and
then
put it back in the
pinions,
and
I
press it down.
Yeah. So be inspired. More buttons.
Yeah, I am trying to be creative.
Yeah, that's cool.
Let's see if they can make it come to life.
We had some people that came in and, you know, they actually drew. They went, they took the paper, and they drew their own buttons.
Took out, drew. They
yeah.
did some great stuff.
They had some really nice drawings.
Interesting.
Yeah. Too bad they didn't leave any behind. You know, they took it all with them.
Do you have a card?
I have an email. I don't have a card. I can write my email.
Oh.
Next year when we get here, I mean, next year we'll have a little bit more. This is our first year.
Yeah. Eric Ambrise?
Eric, you meet him?
I worked landscaping with that guy.
Oh, really?
I know, yeah, he's on my Facebook.
Oh, wow.
For real, where is he?
He's right now, he's working. He was going to come by at 7.
Well, all right.
Yes, anime shop.
Oh yeah, it's my shop. Yeah, if you're interested, I can make any kind of like character or anything. I know right now I based myself mostly on girls, but I can make different kinds of items and stuff, requests. And right now my signature or the patches takes me three to 4 days depending, but they're all handmade.
Very nice.
Oh, this is
you.
How much is this one?
$5.
This is on Folio, I think. Right? Folio, right?
No. Umero Alchemist.
And they look similar. It reminds me of... Yeah.
I was going to make a Soul Eater once, but I didn't have the fabric.
Are you thinking
for Pokemon Go? I just did on Valor. All the way.
So how long does it take you to make these?
Like one of these takes me about probably like 30 minutes, depending on the design and everything. So... It varies in sizes.
Like this as well?
Yeah, like this is my most expensive because I do take a lot of hours. Sometimes, like for the scarves, 1 to 2 hours for the detail on the sewing. And the same with the pillows and the wrist.
What about... That's his, right?
Yeah, that's his art.
He does requests on Facebook all the time.
Yeah.
Or at least he shares them there.
Yeah. I actually requested the One Piece.
Oh,
from
yeah.
My fiance, and yeah, he loved
yeah.
it. He's an amazing artist.
Huh? Yeah.
I think it's all Star Wars. Not only that, Walking Dead as well, right there.
Ah, that's heartbreaking.
Well, it happened like years ago.
Oh, in the comics.
Yeah, which like, I never read in my life.
No, I've never read them.
Me neither, but I already knew this time. You wouldn't believe what it's like.
Oh.
Hey, how you doing, guys?
Did you do this art?
No, my wife does.
Oh. Very nice.
We're over there.
What about the cost? How long would it take you to make the cost?
Actually, I had this made in the UK.
The UK, and yeah. you got it?
Didn't have, yeah, after 4 months.
Wow. It looks super accurate.
Yeah, actually it is.
It's
a replica. I'm a sand trooper.
Yeah.
Heck yeah, right in our dunes. For real.
That's your wife, right?
Yes.
You make the art, right?
Huh?
You make the art?
Yes.
How long does it take to make them?
Well, like the watercolors, it could be like in 4 hours, but the acrylic, it takes like two days or 3 days.
Do you make him hand drawn, right?
Yeah. You mean it like not digital? Is that what you mean?
Yeah, like
yeah. Yeah. I don't know how to do that digital stuff.
I kind of learned through YouTube.
Oh, digital?
Yeah, yeah.
I tried, but I guess I don't have the patience to keep watching it and reviewing it.
Yeah, it takes dozens of hours.
I kind of understand a little bit, but...
I mean, your art doesn't really need it.
Oh, thank you.
No problem.
So you're a digital artist?
Well, we met in a graphic design class.
Okay.
But I really haven't been doing much in it.
Oh, just you do it?
I was just there for like a general class.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. It was fun.
And you're selling all swollen comics, right?
Yes.
A dollar?
I'm going to go sticker now.
$0.50. 50 cent comic.
What? Super tiny minifigures? Cool stuff.
Hello.
Hello.
There's no part I think what he's going to. Oh yeah, you can get the Instagram thing because I also have social media. There's also right there for that one, if possible, for that one over there. So I think these are various artists.
Classic Batman, of course.
Full Metal Alchemist. Oops. Kind of looks like the other.
Oh, the person that I think like a while ago over there?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Very.
That glare is killer though.
Yes.
It's all digital or the art?
Sorry.
Is the art made digital or like hand drawn?
No, it's hand drawn.
All of it?
Yes, except for the Seasons of Print. I printed this, and the rest of these have copies, so if you're interested, you can...
It takes like a few hours, or...?
It takes a couple of days.
The art?
Yeah.
What about the, that?
I didn't make those. You have to ask him about
that. Bizu.
Oh. How much time is the drawing, and then how much time is the coloring?
It depends on how big it is, but like, this took me 3 days, this took me 4 days.
Wow. I imagine at least a day or two of that was coloring.
Mainly sketching.
Mainly? Mm-hmm. Alright. Cool.
I have more. If you were...
Very cool stuff.
Well, nice
art. In about
half an hour.
Did you want to ask him about this?
Oh yeah, how do you make this?
These, we use a pegboard. A pegboard that's on. It'll be easier if I show you than if I explain it. Basically, that's how you make it. Okay, this is a pegboard that you use, and then you just add every printer bead one by one. And once you create it, you put like a, it's like a wax paper that you put on top and you just iron it. So once you iron it, it just melts it. Melts it like this. But usually that's how it begins.
Like an 8-bit type.
Sort of, yeah. And then if you do something, let's say some, after that you have to like tape it so that it stays in place. You make holes in the back, and then that's when you iron after that. Where is it? That's how you basically do it. After you iron it, you have to make all those little holes in the back so it could breathe, so that when you iron it, it doesn't get all heat up and it melts all nasty. Which that one is this one. It's Espeon.
That is very cool.
Yeah, it's pretty big.
Whoa, that's huge.
I didn't bring that one because it was too big, but maybe next year.
You have to get like several of those like plastic like things in order to make them that large?
Well, yeah, because that one took about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. That one took 12. But it doesn't really use the entire pegboard. It used like two of them, but it only used like about this much wasn't used, you know what I mean?
Okay.
And then the ones on the side for like the ears, it just got like barely the tip of its ear. So does it make sense? It didn't really use the whole pegboard, but you still had to put it to use that little end.
So you melted them like one at a time?
One at a time, yeah.
Oh, no problem.
And I'm right there at, it's Bizu on Instagram.
We got all of them.
Yeah, okay. We got
I don't have cards right now, but
yeah, I mean, we got it.
Yeah, right. It's cool.
Facebook.
Yeah, come out and help us next year. We've got a huge year. It's really successful.
So, are you skipping Christmas this year? Or?
Yeah, skipping Christmas, so I'm going to maybe take my kid again to wreck the whole thing. So, maybe we'll
have
a seasonal haunted house in October.
Oh,
so,
okay.
That's kind of like ours, but it's a more like.
Amazing example.
Well, ours is more kid friendly.
Yeah. But,
crystal clear face painting. Nice. Oh, also,
Legacy
over here.
Well, me, I'm retired from that kind of stuff because it's too. I guess in the cold, it's too much because I got to write it down.
Yeah, these are
something. And it's. Well, it, tough on the body.
It wasn't cold this year at all.
But it's also tough on the body because when I did it, I used to dedicate so many hours to it.
Yeah.
My body would just get exhausted afterwards. You know?
Well,
I assume you
did. What is this?
Oh, it's just our magazine.
It's our magazine that we did.
We just did this so we can get our name out there real quick. We spread 20,000 issues around town. And we just wanted to advertise for our local community. So we just had people check. Are you using this for fun or are you guys part of a promotion group?
We're for to cover the event.
Okay.
Yeah, we do cool faces, we do masks, and we do cheeks.
We say do masks, what do you mean by that?
We're good. Is it like a quick face paint?
Yeah. They take about 5 minutes. Maybe three for the small ones.
The cheek and
The cheek ones, like this stuff takes like 5 minutes, 3 minutes, 3 minutes. Depends on what designs you guys get. But they are all
Alright, so without further ado, we're gonna go ahead and do our youth division first, followed by adult, followed by group, alrighty? So, first off, we're gonna be going with number one, Garrett Espinosa, and he is Titan from the video game Destiny. Round of applause, please. Guys, thank you. Okay. Now, while he gets the much needed help he needs to get down, we'll go ahead and have our second person come on up. Please welcome Jake Farno as Ash Ketchum from Pokemon.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jacob. Very good. Alrighty, next up we have Gustavo Becerra as Foxy the Pirate. Come on further up. Don't be shy. The judges don't bite that much. Alrighty, thank you so much, Gustavo. Next one up is Rodolfo Becerra as Bonnie the Bunny. I'm craving pizza now. Okay, next one up is Chloe Dotton as Tammy. Not sure if she's... No? Alrighty. Next one up, Kately Francis as Marionette from FNAF. Come on up. To the front, that way your adoring fans can say hi and all that good stuff. Alright, thank you. Alrighty, guys. Next up is number 8, Ellie Francis as Golden Park Angel. Eli? Alrighty, thank you, Eli, I assume. Alrighty, thank you so much. Next up, contestant number 9, Isabel Campos as Rey from Star Wars. Alrighty. Next up is contestant number 10, Joshua Hendricks as Naruto from Naruto. Strike a pose for the judges. Super cool. Thank you so much. All right. How about that, Joshua? Nice. All righty. Next one up, contestant number 11, with Karma Miller as CL from Black Butler.
I'm changing the battery, that's my major goal. I think they're gonna have an intermission, obviously.
Alrighty. Last one for our youth division. Please welcome contestant number 12, Angelo, as Steven from Steven Universe. Alright, perfect. Okay, I really like the shirt. Alrighty, so we'll go ahead and go on with our adult division, and I'll go ahead and grab the list right now. So, Justin Smith as Fido Getsuga Tensho Ichigo from Bleach. Alright, great. Alrighty, for our second contestant, please welcome Adriana Alvaro as the spirit, the chorus spirit from Princess Mononoke. That is amazing. Alrighty. Please welcome contestant number 3, Robert Espinosa as Hunter from video game Destiny.
War, best of red!
applause for contestant number 4, Sarai Games, guys, as Takashi Shirogane from Voltron Legendary Defender. This is super edgy Takashi. Alrighty, next up, please give a warm welcome to number 5, TJ Mulligan as Reaper from Overwatch. Go ahead and get to the middle, TJ. There we go. Alright, thank you so much, TJ. Very good presence. Alrighty, please welcome contestant number 6, Diana Billingsley and Kona Billingsley as Sariya from Dragon Age Mage and Kona Dragon Age Mabari. Contestant number 7, Jacob Kirkman as Jane Cobb from Firefly. Oh, no, hold your applause. Alrighty, please welcome contestant number 8 as Ricky Hyman as The Punisher. Okay, anyway, let's go on to number 10, and Heather Welch as a Sith. Please welcome contestant number 11, Cody Beecher as Roadhog. Contestant number 12, Alex Johnson as Bonnie from Five Nights at Freddy's. Alright, that's awesome. Okay, please welcome contestant number 15, Michelle Alegría as Camillo from The Prince of Roses? The Prince? The Prince? The Prince of Roses. salad. That was so fabulous. Okay, next one up, number 16, Jake Greener as Jintoki from Suntama. One up. Please welcome contestant number 17, Rin Becerra, as Blue Tundra from Shimoneta. Good, inexpensive superhero idea for a mask. I have tons of them too. I don't even use them. I should use it more. Alright. Next one. Let's go ahead and welcome contestant number 18, Joshua Brown, as the plague doctor from Dr. Birdie. Out of pocket full of posies in his pockets. Probably. Alrighty, number 19, Carla Correll as Link from Legend of Zelda. Contestant number 20, Henry Small as Steampunk Knight from, you know, Steampunk style. One up is contestant number 21, Jarrett Best as Lord Zedd from Power Rangers. Contestant number 22, Robert Lalonde as Deadpool from, of course, Deadpool. From Lilo and Stitch. Yeah. Awesome. All righty. Thank you so much. Mahalo. All righty. Next one up, number 24. Holanda Cisneros as Esmeralda from The Hunchback of Notre Dame.
I don't know if you would listen.
and wonder, were you once an outcast too? God help the outcast, hungry from birth. Show them the mercy they don't find honor. God help my people, we look to you still. God help the outcast, nobody will.
Thank you.
Lovely boys. Thank you for that. Alrighty, next one up, please give a round of applause for contestant number 25, Margo Soto as Yuko Enoshima from Danganronpa. We have a duo. All right, perfect. Number 26, Paulina Adame and Edgar Valtierra as Robin and Chrome from Fire Emblem. Charlotte Wilson and Chris Smart as Jay and Silent Bob. Alright, that was awesome. Alright, hey, another duo. Okay, please give a warm welcome to contestant number 28, Jacob Miller and Trisha Miller from Borderlands, Salvador and Handsome Jack. That's shading though. Their butts glow. That's cool. Alrighty. Very good. Next up, contestant number 29, Lily Brenna, Linmu, as Arcanine from Pokemon. Human, that's how they would act. Very good. Very, very good. Alrighty, contestant number 30, Phoebe Desposito as Captain America. Very good. Excellent. Very patriotic. Alrighty, next one up, please give a warm welcome to contestant number 31, Ashley as Zoro from One Piece.
Oh yeah!
Very good. Thank you so much, Ashley. Alrighty. Next up, we have contestant number 32. With Matthew as Luffy from One Piece. Yeah. Alrighty, we we have one more left, and then we're going to go ahead and start on the group. Okay? Please welcome, oh, another duo. Please welcome contestants number 33, Nilceo and Jessica as Israel and Aurelion Sol from League of Legends. A very good applause for all of our contestants from our adult division. Giselle Espinosa, Kelly Espinosa, as Oshima Yuko, Maeda Atsuko, Takahashi Minami from AKB48.
And I'll get the air.
Please give them a warm round of applause. Base and Akihabara are very, very nice. Alrighty, so for our second group, we have Brittany, Desiree, Nicole, Tennessee, Emilio, and Elliot. They're going to be presenting their skit from Rise of the Guardians as... I guess this group need not any introduction, but I will go ahead and do it. I think we all know them from our childhoods. Easter Bunny, Jack Frost, Sandman, the Tooth Fairy, Pitch, and North, or as we know him, Santa.
No, stop it!
Can't use your return to argue.
Sorry, I'm not allowed to get to work when I'm here. Am I right, Sandy?
You might have
bad
reflexes,
but I'm not going to move my tail. It's been nothing but trouble me for me.
Challenge! Did I hear a challenge?
What?
So nice to finally get notice. Now that I am back and strong,
hey, Sandy,
I will make all children stop believing in
this.
And the world shall be taken over by fear and darkness, and you will regret the day that.
JT, Buck, and Veronica Dare from Halo 3, ODST.
Oh, no.
I do not like that cameraman.
What? Squad, what's your status? You still with me, but...
Yeah.
I hit pretty hard. My hatch won't open. How about yours?
Works great.
Right. When you get done fooling around, I could use some help.
Did I do something wrong? Because the only thing I regret when you and me first met, not knowing you were a spook, I would have been a lot less charming.
That's what I miss most about you, Buck. The way your mouth has always been faster than your brain. Look, don't start about my job. We both agreed to end it.
That was years ago, Veronica. I'm a bit fuzzy on the details. There must have been plenty of other sets before me. Why pick me for the safari?
First, you're the best soldier I know. And second, you really don't remember that night? What you asked me in the morning?
I'm not getting an answer.
Say again, Buck. You're breaking up.
I said, stay put. I'm on my way.
We miss our LZ. This grid is packed with Covenant. Be careful.
I appreciate the concern.
Won't be much of a rescue if you're dead.
I actually have Covenant. I will definitely cosplay as 0267.
Give this one to you. Pasha. Okay. Let's make Pasha. Okay. Alrighty, next group. Oh, this is the last group, so this pretty much concludes our masquerade. So I'll go ahead and announce them right now. Please welcome our last but not least, number four contestants, Dakota Burnett and Kayla Durian as Denmark and Prussia from Italia. Sorry, I was doing it like the super dumb way. I guess they're just gonna connect it like civilized people. Okay, I'm not very tech savvy. Don't pick on me. I was doing my best.
Look in the off court.
I'm gonna go to the
Alrighty, so please give a round of applause to all of our skit contestants. Alrighty guys, so next up we're going to be doing some K-pop dances while our amazing judges judge the masquerade and find out who the winners are, which by the way, I'm so sorry, I didn't get a chance to introduce them, so I don't know if you guys would like to turn around, or I don't know if you guys are comfortable standing up, I don't know. But anyway, we have two international guests this year from Mexico. One is Nacho's cosplay. And Nacho. Say hello to Nacho. So he's very amazing. He's been doing a lot of competitions and everything. He's gotten tons of prizes over there. So I figured, hey, we should invite him. He's pretty good. All right, and then we have Nami Suki. So, good round of applause. Alright, so she's been doing cosplay for many years now, so she's been winning tons of awards in Mexico, so it only felt right to invite her here. Now, we have Miss Chainsaw over here. Again, she's been doing cosplay for many, many years, very talented, so. Then the next one we have Kyuki, such a cute name. So, very cute doll over there. Again, she's been doing cosplay for a lot of times. They're both very talented people and doing it for many years, and we're very grateful to have them here. Next up, last but not least, is... Kay Pickle, sorry, it's like I'm getting nervous up here. So, next one is Kay Pickle. So, she's been featured in tons of things, whether it's like magazines or... all that fun stuff, webcomics, all that fun stuff. So, with very good cost. I mean, she knows how to make her own armor. That's amazing in my book. I can, like, barely tie my shoelaces, so it's very good. All right, you guys. So, I'm not sure if the judges would like to judge here or maybe in a more private area. So, we'll give them a few minutes. But to entertain you guys in the meantime, we have our special K-pop groups that are going to be performing. So, grab a box.
Bye.
in vain. See? Stay with me, it's enough to be getting it.
Give it up for Gio. How about you, my dear? What's your name?
Isla.
Isla. How about you, good sir?
Rodrigo.
Rodrigo. Give it up. That's like a soap opera name, Rodrigo. All right, very good. How about you, Miss?
Nancy.
Nancy. Give it up for Nancy. Very good. These are like soap opera names. Okay, how about you?
Dean.
Give it up for Dean, please. All right. How about you, Miss?
Perla.
Perla. Give it up for Perla. Alrighty. Last but not least, our next lovely lady. What is your name?
Ali.
Ali. All right. Nice to meet you guys. Thank you so much. Give them a round of applause, please. Again, thank you guys so much for coming all the way, you know, to here. We really appreciate it. And we want to make sure that K-pop is more widely known, especially here in Yuma. I mean, we do have a few fans. We do have a very, very good following here. We just need to cultivate it. And hopefully, just like the conventions in Mexicali and in Mexico in general, we can actually have K-pop competitions where people, hard workers like these, dance their butts off and basically win money, glory, prize, all that fun stuff. Alrighty, so we'll go ahead and start. You guys ready? You guys nervous? Alright, let's shake that nervous off, guys. Let's go ahead and start.
Just follow. Now, somebody will make me feel. I know. This darling dagger is
nerd.
Pretty awesome, though. They keep skipping songs. Always.
totally enough minutes.
You want to stop recording right now?
No. I mean, we'll play a little bit.
Oh.
So after they start dancing, we're going to announce the winners, right?
Okay.
That's fine. All right.
For real, what's DJ doing? Why is DJ screwing it up? So, get another DJ. Have someone that can continue a song that everybody's enjoying, like, all the way through.
Yeah.
appropriate. They were done dancing, so she changed the song. That's good. I mean, but honestly, that's what I feel like this dancing is about.
For your awesome dances. Hopefully you guys had as much fun as I did. Alrighty, so now the judges are ready to give out their prizes. They're just doing a few honorable mentions in there. Sorry guys. Thank you so much.
Best in youth category goes to Garrett Espinoza for his Titan from Destiny.
Oh, you know what? They're all on stage anyways.
Yeah. That was a joke, by the way. If you hear my voice saying
Also, we would love to thank our sponsors for these prizes. The Yuma Art Center, the Mandalorian Warriors, and FanQuest. Thank you so much for these prizes.
Yes.
So cute.
You're getting it, right?
Oh yeah, I'm getting it.
For me, right?
I'm getting the whole thing.
So now we're going to go into the honorable mentions into the adult category. This one is my honorable mention. That goes to Hayaso and Jessica. I'm so sorry for pronouncing it wrong. For the League of Legends cosplay.
This is my honorable mention, Justin Smith, Ichigo.
And this is my honorable mention, Cody Beecher as Roadhog.
Alright, and then this is my honorable mention, I chose the AKB48 group. Guess come up! Oh, it's an honorable mention.
I think Roadhog lost his prize. Yeah, he decided to get on that side of the stage, so she handed the two magazines to the stage guy, and he handed it to the sword person, rather than Roadhog. Roadhog just grabbed his certificate and left. He's not even, hanging out on stage. Oh, he came back. He's gonna go for his prize and they're gonna be like, we already gave it.
Okay, so the best characterization in the Adult Division goes to Charlotte Wilson and Chris Smart for their Jay and Bob. Is Jay and Silent Bob in the house?
Oh no.
With their boombox.
know that.
Against a brick wall.
Best armor goes to Jarrett Vest for Lord Zedd.
Easter Bunny. I've only seen videos.
I know it's a bear.
You could practically make it the game out of Flash from what I've seen.
Before I forget, when we announce the winners, we ask that you stay on stage. That way our media and photographers can take pictures of you for newspaper or whatever type of, like, you know, stuff they want to do. So, thank you.
Publicity's sake.
Alright, so we're going to do skit next, and then we'll tell you the best overall afterwards. So the best costumes in the skit category was Jerry Almada for his Halo 3 ODST.
Help them in their cosplay, such as foam, glue guns, scissors, all sorts of stuff to help them with their props and continue doing what they love. So thank you, Art Center, for that. Round of applause, guys.
Now we move into the top three. All right, so overall, best in novice, we have Robert Espinoza from his Hunter from Destiny. Next up, we have Best in Journeyman, Jacob and Trisha Miller from Borderlands. Oh. And last but not least, Best in Masters, we have Adriana Alvardigo for her Forest Spirit. Guys, she has grass growing out of her feet. Check that out, it's so cool. Watch their amazing skits in their shows today. Really appreciate it. Thanks for coming out, everyone. Thanks for staying so late. And let's give a round of applause to all the contestants.
Thanks for having me. This was a lot of fun. Congratulations to all the contestants.
Again, please stay on stage. That way our photographers can take a picture and be sure to get a little bit close to it. You know, get close to each other. Pretend you know each other. You know, little people in the front.
They're all facing the other way.
Still, but you're getting the...
Yeah, I'm getting zoom-ins.
I'm going to be using images from the I'll give them credit like
you did last year. Alright guys, please give one final round of applause to all our contestants. They did a great job.
Loving that bunny. That bunny is.
And again, remember that the fun and party doesn't stop there. Please stay tuned. This room is gonna be transformed into a geek rave. So get your glow sticks out and break a move. Cut a little rug.
Oh, it's all cool. Go ahead.
So, unfortunately, I can't really make it through the whole thing. There's going to be more stuff going on, and I have to go elsewhere, unfortunately. So I won't be able to cover it, but I will do my best to see what happens afterwards. And my cameraman here, Mike, you can switch it. Right. He will come here later on and maybe record some footage, so I'm not sure how that will turn out, but...
You
see.
Oh no! The most pure mistake of them all! You didn't see anything, I just happened to lose the car.
Like the best bachelors around, that's it?
Yeah.
And you're inviting me?
Yeah, just join the group.
You
like 450
members. Yeah. Oh yeah, I killed myself in like 5 seconds.
Fine, dude, you just gotta
fight better people. I've played it for 2 years, that's it.
That's fine.
I thought I was good until I came here. I always think I'm good in soccer against the
That's exactly how everyone is.
Gotta play me.
I'm the best.
What do you every time about? Oh, my man. What's 1v1? Yeah. My man's Luigi.
He's definitely joined the group before he forgets.
What's it called?
Game of County Smash.
Alright, someone just needs to accept their play.
Is that your controller too, right there?
No.
Mm-hmm.